There once existed a terrible family that has captured the imaginations of scientists and researchers alike deep within South America in a remote area of the Earth. These elusive creatures, which have a long, slender body and razor-sharp teeth, are thought to be the final extant dinosaur ancestors. Sebecidae, an animal that is unlike anything else on Earth, may hold the key to understanding the mysteries of our planet's prehistoric history. The Sebecidae family of extinct crocodyliforms, which ranged in size from relatively small to big, lived between the Paleocene and Miocene epochs, or roughly 66 to 5 million years ago. The largest species, like Sebecus dicerorhinus, may reach lengths of up to 16 feet, while the smallest species, Caiman Paleocene, was estimated to be less than 3 feet long. It's possible that Sebecid's stature had an effect on their ecology and behavior. Smaller species may have relied on smaller prey items or a different hunting technique, whilst larger species may have been better able to take on larger prey. Due to variations in their energy needs and ecological roles, larger species may have also had a different effect on their habitat than smaller ones. Sebecids have a flattened, elongated skull with a long snout and a row of teeth running down each side. The skull differed significantly from those of contemporary crocodiles and other crocodyliforms in a number of ways. The skull's elongated morphology shows that Sebecids used a different eating method than contemporary crocodiles. Sebecids probably used their extended snouts and keen teeth to capture and kill prey, possibly in a more active hunting method as opposed to ambush strategies or scavenging. Sebecids had several pointed teeth that were recurved in shape, making them ideal for gripping and slicing through prey. Since the teeth of Sebecids were conical rather than flattened and triangular like those of current crocodiles, it is possible that some Sebecid species were specialized for different sorts of prey based on the degree of ornamentation on their teeth. Like modern crocodiles, Sebecids' jaws were modified for a different purpose. Sebecids probably utilized their jaws to grab and manipulate prey items, slashing through tissue and bone with their keen teeth, rather than using raw force to crush and consume prey. Sebecids' comparatively long, narrow jaws may have allowed them to specialize in different types of prey than current crocodiles. Other distinctive characteristics of the skulls of Sebecids include prominent, bony knobs or ridges on the top of the head that may have served as ornaments for display or as points of attachments for muscles. The placement of the eye sockets on the sides of the skull presumably gave Sebecids a larger range of view, which was advantageous for hunting or avoiding predators. Sebecids had 4 well-developed limbs, but they were not out to the sides like modern crocodiles. They were located underneath their bodies. With 5 fingers on each foot and relatively long and thin limbs, Sebecids probably had more movement on land. Sebecids possessed 5 digits on each of their clawed-tipped feet. The claws were probably useful for digging or climbing as well as for grabbing and clinging onto prey. The design of the feet shows that Sebecidae could move swiftly over a variety of surfaces, including rocky or muddy substrates. Sebecids' limb structure probably had a significant impact on their lifestyle and ecology. Compared to current crocodiles, which are better adapted to life in the water, their well-developed limbs indicate that they were designed for a more active lifestyle on land. Sebecids may have been able to specialize on other types of prey or occupy a distinct ecological niche as a result of this. Small, diamond-shaped scales that were organized in overlapping rows covered the Sebecid skin. These scales, known as osteoderms, were made of bone tissue and adhered in the skin. In certain species, the osteoderms were thicker and more ornate, suggesting that they may have offered additional defense against predators or environmental stresses. It's interesting to note that some Sebecids also left skin imprints in the fossil record, which have revealed more details about the texture and patterns of their skin. For instance, skin imprints of some species have been discovered that depict the presence of massive, polygonal tail scales which are missing in contemporary crocodiles. Other species have been discovered with skin impressions that implied the existence of ridged or bumpy scales on the back, perhaps for thermal regulation or concealment. Sebecids were alive between 66 and 23 million years ago, during the Paleogene epoch. They appear to have been numerous and diversified, with species present in both South and North America, according to fossil evidence. Sebecids inhabited a range of habitats, including terrestrial settings, coastal areas, freshwater rivers, lakes, and swamps. While some sebecids were more suited to living on land, others were aquatic in nature. Numerous sebecid species have been discovered in fossilized remains from freshwater areas, like rivers and lakes. Sebecids most likely had easy access to a variety of water creatures and fish in these habitats. Some sebecids, like the species Sebecus echeorhinus, exhibited traits including streamlined bodies and webbed feet that suggested they were adapted for living in the water. It's possible that they led a more maritime existence because other sebecids have been discovered in coastal and marine deposits. Finally, certain sebecids had more terrestrial characteristics and were better suited to life on land. The species Labidosaurus hamatus, for instance, had lengthened hind limbs that suggested it was specialized for running and climbing. It lived in what is now Wyoming, USA. Other sebecids possessed large, flattened heads with sharp teeth, which are characteristics that point to a more terrestrial existence, such as the species Sebecus dicerorhinus. Sebecids were meat-eating creatures, hence they consumed flesh. According to fossil evidence, their diet was wide and varied, with several species going for various kinds of prey. The long, narrow snouts and numerous sharp teeth of many sebecid species suggest that they were developed for grabbing and slicing through fish and other aquatic prey. Others appear to have been designed for grabbing larger animals because they had wider, more robust skulls and larger fangs. Sebecus dicerorhinus, for instance, was a species that inhabited what is now Brazil. It featured a broad, flattened cranium and big, recurved teeth that were useful for grabbing and slicing into flesh. Various terrestrial animals, including small mammals, reptiles, and birds, were probably among the prey items this species hunted. Sebecids with relatively short, deep snouts and elaborately decorated teeth, like the genus Langstonia, may have hunted different kinds of prey than other sebecids. For instance, Langstonia had teeth with serrated edges that may have been effective for grabbing and retaining prey or for cutting through hard plant material. Except during the breeding season, when males compete for access to females, they were typically lonely creatures. In some fossil strata, some sebecid species, including Bredisuchus bonaparte, have been discovered in groups, which may indicate that they were gregarious animals. Instead of engaging in any social interaction, it's also feasible that these animals were simply drawn to the same area by environmental variables. Sebecids probably laid eggs in order to mate. In order to lay their eggs, female sebecids probably excavated holes in the ground or constructed nests out of plants. The heat of the environment would have been used to incubate the eggs, and once they hatched, the young would have been left on their own. In such species, the temperature at which the eggs are incubated determines the sex of the hatchlings, with lower temperatures producing primarily females and higher temperatures producing primarily males. Similar temperature-dependent sex determination mechanisms may have existed in sebecids. One hypothesis holds that Sebecidae were impacted by variations in freshwater supply brought on by sea level changes. Sebecids were able to survive in both freshwater and saltwater habitats, but a drop in their ideal habitat may have resulted from changes in sea level and river drainage patterns. Sebecidae may have gone extinct due to human activity as well. Early hominids appeared about the same time as the late Miocene, and it's conceivable that human habitat degradation and hunting led to the extinction of sebecids and other huge mammals. So this was all about Sebecidae, the descendant to the dinosaurs. If you want to get more such updates, hit the bell icon and subscribe to this channel. Also, let us know in the comment section how you find it. By knowing about unique species, we get an idea of how the world, climate, and wilderness was in historic times. We get to know about several new concepts we never knew ever existed. Did you know who is called the hunter hippo of South Africa? It's Antaeosaurus, who was huge in size and weight. Click the video on your screen to know more about it.